go on and on. Can't understand how I last so long. I must have superpowers. Rap 225,000 hours. Get a calculator, do the math. I made 1,000 songs that made you move, yeah. And for the last 300 months, I made 16 albums with me on the front. And they bump. Where you get your beats? I heard 93 rappers say, like me. Two singers and 10 comedians. And I'm still gonna yell it every time you see me in. What's my favorite word? Why they gotta say it like short? You know they can't play on my court. Can't hang with the big dogs, stay on the porch. Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle. Where you get that from? Grab a mic, spin one. Let me step the MC 8 Ball and MJG. Keep spinning that beat to the IMP. Bun B, that's Texas, baby. Ballin' B, that's Memphis, baby. Short dog, that's open, baby. Ain't nothing but pimpin' each SG. My C got locked up, but these real dudes still know they got some. Give a what you say. Short dog, with UGK. Do you really wanna be like me? Spit game like Snoop and T.I.P. Pretty girls in the VIP. They can't be Dre. They don't need ID. Go to whistle.
Yeah, if you can't hang with the big dog, you know, stay on the porch. Reaper back at you again, but coming back from the green room again. Let's get to the topic today, but first we'd like you to subscribe to the Reaper, because I'm doing good things here at Reaper. Hussein Campbell and Kwame Brown, right? Are they smart businessmen? Because we see Kwame Brown, you know, snapping on people. He stayed quiet for 20 years or whatever. Now, I'm not saying that the brother don't got a right to come out, but you know what? We see Kwame, you know, he was a quiet, we thought he was an introvert guy, and he's coming out snapping on Steven Jackson and Matt Barnes. They triggered him or whatever, and, you know, he came out on Stephen A. Smith or whatever, but Kwame is just a smart businessman, Pauls, you know, I mean, he's a smart businessman. And he's like a comedian, you know, he's talking about his pain and, you know, he's got a lot of jokes, you know, to say in there with it to keep people interested. And people are always interested on drama, you know, the Reaper keep it 1000. So he's just talking about his pain, you know, just like a comedian or just like anyone else, you know, in entertainment. They get up there and talk about their pain and he does it, you know, very funny. That's why he came out with the outfit like Hussein Campbell, and he talked like Jack, and, you know, he snap on them, and Stephen A. Smith, and, you know, he does it in a comedic kind of way, an entertaining kind of way to keep it funny, you know, the Reaper keep it 1000. Also, if people are addicted to drama, you know, and they're addicted to, you know, somebody going at it with someone else. You know, that's what the internet is all about. That's what it's built up on. You know, the more drama that you kick or whatever, you know, the more popular that you gonna be. Because Kwame had a YouTube channel, and like he said, he been talking about some of the same things he talked about. Even Ticket TV said that, you know, but he wasn't as popular as he is now. And he gets together with the other popular YouTubers, you know, that people are interested in, you know, like Hussein Campbell, you know, he's got a big following. I think they're both over 300 and something, almost 400, you know, subscribers or whatever, the Reaper keep it 1000. And, you know, both of them got a big following now. So why wouldn't he be on the YouTube channel, you know, 2 times a day or whatever, just like Hussein is, you know? I mean, they're both on there. But Kwame Brown, you know, he came in, you know, he talk about Hussein Campbell, but he came in as a victim too. And the reason I say that Kwame came in as a victim, because he say for 20 years that y'all been talking about me or whatever, I got a right to speak now, you know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. And nobody was going to question that. And, you know, the people that he was speaking about, you know, was coming at him and kind of like making him the laughing stock among his peers in the NBA, even though I don't think he was, but, you know, because there's been Brian Scalabrine, there's been a bunch of busts, you know, that was number one, if you just want to say a bust or whatever, you want to use that word bust far as NBA standards, but he's not a bust far as life, but the word bust, you know, means that, you know, you a scrub all the way around, but Kwame Brown took this for 20 years and was quiet, you know, and so now he's coming out, you know, vehemently at people, but he's doing it in a funny way, and, you know, my man got some jokes why he's doing it, you know, the Reaper keep it 1,000, the drama and jokes will always, you know, captivate people, you know, on this internet, the Reaper keep it 1,000, and that's why people are captivated, you know, by him. A lot of people didn't even know who Kwame Brown was, you know, I mean, he hasn't played in the NBA, you know, for a long time or whatever, you know, and they didn't even know who Kwame Brown was, you know, but now everybody mostly knows who Kwame Brown is because, you know, of the way, you know, he presented, you know, his life, you know, on the internet. He don't got to write a book, you know, because he's doing a book every day when he's snapping on people, and he's doing it in a funny type of way, and it's drama, and it addicts people, and this is why, you know, Kwame Brown is relevant today. You know, I mean, I know he was an NBA star, but this is why he's relevant today. And then now that his platform has grown, he gets together with other people whose platform has grown, like Insane Hussein Campbell, a.k.a. Elmer Fudd, you know, the Reaper keep it 1,000, you know, because he's like a cartoon character or whatever. Now, where he gets his following at or whatever, you know, he's a smart businessman too, but I don't know why you would want to go down his path, you know. He gets his by, you know, being crazy, you know, off of his life and off of his pain or whatever, you know. He turns it into a comedic type of way, but in a different type of way, the Reaper keep it 1,000, in a crazy, insane type of way or whatever that keeps people addicted. And it's funny, you know, and it's dramaful, you know. He's more like a cartoon character. He'd just say some outlandish stuff or whatever, you know, and it keeps people interested, you know, in him, because he talks about, you know, his molestation. He makes funny jokes out of it, which is not funny, you know, to most people, but, you know, he makes funny jokes out of that because he came in as a victim at first, you know, just like Kwame did. You know, Kwame came in like, these guys are talking about me and I've been quiet and this, that, and the other. Well, Hussein came in the same way. You know, I mean, he came in, you know, talking about Afrika Bambaataa and, you know, his molestation or whatever, and it wasn't funny. And then next thing you know, he turned into this gangster thug, you know, with these Popeye arms, and then he started acting crazy and insane and saying outlandish stuff or whatever. But he got people, you know, gravitating to him, you know, off of his pain, the Reaper keep it 1,000, just like Kwame did, you know, I mean, off of things that he was going through or whatever, where people say, oh man, that's messed up, you know. And then next thing you know, it started to be in a joking, ranting, dramaful, comedic type of way, which keep people interested on this internet, you know. And this is why these guys have a big following or whatever, because it's entertainment. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000, and they making money off of it. You know, they're making money off of it, and, you know, they can get on here and, you know, talk for an hour or whatever they do or whatever, and, you know, Hussein and Kwame could, you know, just go all off on people or whatever. And it's funny to people, and it's, you know, it's addicting. You know, drama is addicting. That's why you see all of your love and hip-hop, basketball-wise, and, you know, whatever they got on TV, you know, Scandal, you know, any type of dramaful, you know, TV show, even in the reality shows was dramaful. They would put all this drama in there, and they was addicting. Well, on the internet, a lot of people watch the internet. They don't watch TV like they used to or whatever. So if you create some drama, you know, and you create a beef between each other or whatever, or somebody or whatever, then, you know, the views start pouring in and the sponsorships and the money start pouring in. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And this is what these guys is doing. And the relevancy, it brings you relevant. So that's a smart businessman tactic. Now, I wouldn't want to go at it like Insane Campbell, because making fun off of his pain and molestation and then his prison, and then he goes out on the hood with all this jewelry and, you know, act like he's the thug of all thugs, and, you know, he'll just say some wild stuff. Even that meltdown that he had the other day, you know, on the internet or whatever, even though he took it down, you know, it made money, it made him more relevant, more popular, more everything. This is why he tell people, well, I don't care if you subscribe, F you, and F my fans and F you, you know, this dude to just say all kind of wild stuff, and I'll bust in your mouth, and this, that, and the other, and, you know, suck my D, and all this, you know, I mean, all of this stuff, you know, people say, you know, at 44 years old, he's very childish, he needs to be put in a mental institution, but also the dude ain't crazy, you know, and everything he say about Kwame, you know, is not crazy either. 1,000, you know, I'm just being honest, just like everything Kwame say about him, you know, it's true, you know, I mean, everything Kwame says about him is not true, and everything Hussein says about Kwame, you know, I mean, Hussein be telling the truth on some of the stuff, but people just think he's just so outlandish and crazy and everything, just like when he said, you know, Kwame is on here for money and views and popularity and everything, you know, and he is, just like they both is, and Kwame says he's not doing it for money or whatever. So, you know, I just think that these is, you know, two smart businessmen. Like I said, I wouldn't want to go at it in the way Hussein goes at it, but, you know, he's making, you know, a lot of paper off of it, and some people only, you know, care about the paper. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000, so that is why he doing it. Reaper, we keep it rough, we keep it raw, we keep it real. We gonna blow the whistle on these brothers. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper, because I'm doing very good things here at Reaper. Reaper out. Peace. Enjoy your day.